back in that Tennessee territory, you remember that stuff called Black Ice?
Oh, yeah. Oh,
a lot
yeah.
of times on Nashville, Memphis, or those runs, come wintertime, there'd be some stuff on the ground. And you were riding Godfather Charles, Soul Taker.
Man.
88 Thunderbird.
Oh, man. Let me tell you what. Let me tell you about this guy.
Ford Taurus.
So you already know.
Yeah.
You already know,
but
right?
I want you to tell me.
Okay. All right.
Because I know the territory.
I'm hot already.
I know the territory. I know the drive.
You know the. All right.
I don't know everything.
No,
that's what
but
I'm asking you.
You know enough. You know enough to get, push my button. All right. So 1988, 89, Memphis territory. Back then, obviously, we don't have cell phones. And when you work that territory, you live in Nashville and you make all the towns out of Nashville. So it's a Monday night. Going to Memphis, Mid-South Coliseum. So we drive from Nashville. Godfather's car, he's had to drive the Ford Taurus. So there's myself, Tony Anthony, Dirty White Boy, and Kim, his girlfriend at the time,
Dirty White Girl.
So we go to Memphis. We get to Memphis. We get to the back door. There's Mr. Coffee.
Yeah.
The show's been canceled. There's a big snowstorm coming. What? Really?
And it's about a 205-mile one-way trip.
Yeah, one-way trips, 205 miles. And we're like, dang, all right, show's been canceled. It is a complete whiteout. I mean, it is, the temperatures drop 30 degrees. It's snowing, sleeting. So nobody's got any experience driving in snow and ice and these kind of conditions. Like, all right, I'll do it. I'll drive, right? By now, there's an inch of ice on the road. The snow's coming down. You can't barely see 2 feet in front of you. And I'm driving, 5 miles an hour, 10 miles an hour at a good spot. And then you look on the side of the road and there's just cars. I mean, it's just car after car after cars has come off the road in the ditch. We're just plugging along, man. White knuckle, right? We're about 60 miles outside of Nashville, maybe even closer than that. Dirty White Girl, she got to use the restroom. I'm like, okay, look, here's the deal. I said, I'll stop, but I'm stopping in the middle of the road. By this point, we're 6 hours in, right? Yeah. And we're still 60 miles out. So we're all standing right in the middle of the interstate. She finishes up there and get back in the car. So Bear, he goes, all right, man, I'll take us in. And I'm like, whoa, wait. I said, look, I got this. Let me just go ahead and take it. He said, no, man, I got it. I was like, it's icy. It's bad. No, man, I got it. I was like, bro, it almost comes to like a fist fight, right? He's like, no, the hell, it's my car.
It's my car.
I'll drive us in the rest of the way. I'm like, fine, to bring us in. So everybody gets back in the car. We take off. Maybe we go 10 feet. We are sideways sliding down the highway until we slide off of the highway into the ditch. We're teetering. 10 feet. I turn to look at him. And he goes, I don't want to hear it. So I don't say a word, right? So he opens his door. He gets out.
Teetering.
I can't go out my side. I'm 8 feet in the air. So I got to slide across, go out his side. So there we are, the four of us on the interstate, standing there. Finally, highway patrolman is coming the other direction. It's 4 a.m. yeah. Now, right? 4:30 in the morning. We're trying to wave him down. We barely see him. He cuts across and pulls up. He's like, what are you guys doing out here? And I want to say, we're freezing our ass off, officer. He says, there's a hotel up at the next exit. Okay, can you give us a ride up there? Yeah, y'all go ahead and get in, right? So Bear, Tony, Kim, they get in the back seat, and I go around, try to get in the front seat, right? He goes, no, 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 no. You're going to have to get in the back. So you got these two human beings right here that are 300 plus pounds. Tony, who was 240.
Yeah.
Fortunately, Kim was maybe 90 pounds. You got all four of us in the back seat of a squad car in the morning. I don't remember how he got the money, but he had to get a wrecker to pull his car out, come back and get us. We ended up getting into Nashville with just enough time, everybody to go home, re-meet up, and then we had to drive to Louisville.
Yeah.
To this day, that story comes up, I instantly get hot. Because I put all that time in, and he wants to come in, take up all the glory on the end, and bring us in, and put us in a ditch with 10 feet.
But he had the grand argument. It's his car.
It was his car. Like, his what car. Am I going to say? Like, yeah, you're right. It's your car. Let's go.
Don't miss a special edition of the Broken Skull Sessions with The Undertaker. One more round exclusively on the WWE Network.